Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopschool.com. Thank you.
So when the containers are deleted, the data is also gone. For example, let me give you the quick example for it. See here. Now I have a one container, what is this, sudo-s, docker-ps. See, I have a container, so it's this container. Okay, and this container I will attach this container. And I got into this container, go to the OPT. And OPT, I will put that one file, I'll create a rajesh.txt. Let me tell you here, this file is very important for me and for my company. Okay, this file is very important. Now if I go var lib docker and if I search this this file, it's still there somewhere in the host machine, and because it's inside the container, you see here, it's there in the diff also and it's there in the mark also. Now you know very well what is the concept of mark and diff, so I don't have to explain it, but this file is there. But the moment you stop this container, docker stop, you see that here this container, and now if I search, see, merge has disappeared, and now the moment I delete this container, you see that, and data is gone. So I'm in a big trouble now, because the data is gone. Containers may get deleted because of system got terminated, system got corrupted or anything, it may have happened, any kind of accident. So now the question is, how can we have the data persistency? That's the problem which we are trying to solve. How can we have containers data persistency? That means the container is gone, but the data should not go. So what is the solution? Solution is Docker volume. Okay, Docker volume. So guys, Docker volume is the way in which the container is gone, but data is not gone. So how can I do that? So guys, there's a volume type. There's a three kind of volume type. There's about three kind of volume type. One is a volume itself. One is like a mount fs, mntfs, and one is temp fs. So now temp fs. Now let's understand this. This will get stored where? Let me close one putty because it's confusing me all the time. Yeah. So this will get stored where? You know, this will get stored in the volume directory. You see here, volume. This will. This place it will store. Here it is. Okay. Now mountfs, any place in the host machine. Host machine, understand that, from where the Docker engine is running, and this is in a memory. So here these are the types of volume supported. Now how can you create this type of volume? So let me do that. So guys, here I have two volumes already. I don't know how come it got created, because I don't remember I created, but it's still there. Can I go and check inside that what is here? And can I go check the data directory? And if I see, what is this? This file. So guys, this file, I see that it's from the Jenkins. So that means the Jenkins container, whenever we create a volume and then store the data in the volume. That means maybe if the containers of Jenkins gone, data is not gone or something like that. So we'll check it out, all this behavior. So let me check it out. CD back. So guys, how to work with this volume? So I'm going to create one volume stock for volume create. Now, if you want to know all the commands, you just click here and create inspect ls rm. So here you can create a volume. You can inspect a volume. Yes, you can inspect the container, image, volumes, network, many things. Any object which is developed by Docker, you can use the inspect. Now you can list the volumes, you can prune the volumes, that means prune means remove unused volumes and remove the volumes also. So can I do one thing, list? Ah, see, this is the two volumes which is here, it's listing it here local. Okay, so can I create a few more volumes also? So yes, let me create. This is a volume for dev, and you see here, list, see here, you got this volume. Now, can I create one more volume? QA. I'm just creating the volume based upon the my visualization. You can create a volume. Now, but the question is, how can we use this volume? That's the question. So now this volume is there. You see here, ls, this volume is there. But how can we use it? So can I use this volume this time? Or you can use this volume also, no problem. But because I created this one, and it has a no file, so I am going to store the file. So how can you map the volume? Docker volume, Docker run hyphen -itd and Ubuntu. Now this command you know very well, correct? Huh? Do you have any questions on this command? Correct, guys?
Yeah.
So now how do I map? So here I say hyphen v. What is the volume name? Dev. And where you inside a container, because run always create a container, remember? So where do you want to map it up? Under the opt Rajesh, something like this. This will be created if it is not accessed. So now you see here dev volume, which is from outside, map inside this. Okay, done, one container. So can I see that container now? So go ahead, and this is the container which got created 6 seconds ago. Can I do one thing? Docker execute. What you want to execute? Df-kh. You see that? OPT Rajesh has come. What is the size? 8 GB, which is my host machine size. Okay. So I got the OPT Rajesh. That's cool, right? So here OPT Rajesh is got created. Now you can store whatever you want. So can I go inside this container and then store something inside this? So let's do that. Attach where df-kh. And here cd opt Rajesh. Here I am typing file Rajesh 1.txt Rajesh. Some dummy files I'm creating, which is very important for me. And you see this is the file. Control C Q. And now can I check this? The file is there or not? Opt Rajesh. See that containers have the file. Now I will delete this container. So Docker stop container, Docker remove and container. Do we have that file? Let's check it out. See dev directory, right? Find dot name Rajesh star, and you see the file is there in the dev. Container is gone. I deleted. You see that here I deleted, but the data is not there. Now can I mount this container, this volume, with other containers? Yes, you can do that. So run again. Can I see that this time new container, right? So Docker execute this container, and what you want to do, df-kh, you see here, and ls and opt Rajesh. See, the same container you mounted here. So did you understand this, guys? Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, this volume.
Yeah, Rajesh, one question. So here, right now, our Ubuntu is our image. So we are adding it. Is that only for Ubuntu, or any image we can mount a volume?
No, sir. You can use it for any images, right?
Any images. Okay.
I'm teaching you not for Ubuntu. Other, we will spend 5 years to learn that Docker extension. So for everything. The command is common for everything. The name may be different. Right?
Yeah, any image we can mount a volume.
Yeah. Any same command. Only the name change, location change. You want it, you do whatever. Right? So this is the one. So now what I need to do, I need to show you another option also. So here, can I list this Docker volume ls? Can I prune it? Volume prune, prune. And if I want to prune, yes. And here you see there how many got prune, which is not used. I think everyone got prune except dev, because dev was in being used. Apart from the rest of the things got not in use. So it's like this. Can I delete this volume? RM dev. And here, see here, it says it's in use. You have to unuse actually first thing. If you stop and then remove, it will work for you. So guys, this is the way we work with volumes. Very important one. And very good way to have the data persistency. You will love it. Now guys, this is the volume, but there is a drawback for this. The drawback is this volume is always stored in the this directory, always. So what do we do in this case? I don't want to store here. I want to store somewhere in the host machine, any other places. So what do we do in this case? Let's go to the OPT directory, mkdir backup. This is my backup, and you have to assume something. This backup directory is a mount from the some external drive. So even though if this node get corrupted or node get crashed, the backup with the file which you have in the OPT backup, because if it got mounted from outside external devices, the data is still there. Okay, are you getting my points? You have to assume this right now. Are you getting my points?
Yeah.
Run and then hyphen itd ubuntu. This command you know very well. This time hyphen v, instead of giving the volume name, you have to give the path actually. And here what you want, where you want to mount inside this. So Raju, inside the container of that Ubuntu, I want to mount in opt Raju. And you see here, some file I am writing in the host machine. See the badges. Here Raju 1a.txt. I write, can I show you in the containers docker exec. This is the container and ls. What is the opt Raju? See here Raju.txt. Can I create some file inside the container through containers or touch? OPT Raju and here what file I want to create? Raju2.txt and cls. See, so container is gone. Let me docker stop container and docker remove container, and here you see the file is still there and not removed. So that is the way also persisted. Even though this node got crashed, you won't have any problem because the data was anyways in an external drive. So yes, that is the way you can also do that. Now, this is a memory. Memory means it will be there in the memory, and the memory, the file will be there in the memory as long as that system is not rebooted. And if the system is rebooted, that this data is lost. So guys, these are the three ways to have the container data persistency. Let me tell you guys, there are many ways also available if you install the Docker plugin, but that is not a topic for us because Docker plugin, we are not using it. The reason is we are not going towards the SWAM. We are going towards the Kubernetes. So that is the reason we will migrate from this topic to the Kubernetes and will not deep dive into the plugins which will take you to the SWAM, which is a competitor of Kubernetes. So do you understand this here? Everyone?
Yeah.
Okay. So now the question was, the question was, because I covered the volume, which you will do the lab little bit later, but before that, I would like to cover the Docker file also. Now, let me show you. So here, here I'm talking about the method 2. What is the Docker file? So guys, Docker file is an interesting topic actually, but you need to know a little bit of rules. So first let me show you the demo and then I'll talk about the rules. Otherwise you'll not understand what I'm talking about. So first thing, see, my manager had asked me to install all these things, right? Remember, I didn't write the commands, but these were the something which I had it. So I'm going to write a Docker file for it and this will be run automatic. So what is the base image? I will write a from. What is that? Ubuntu. Who are you? Maintainer. What is your name, email address, whatever you want to give it, you can give it here, no problem. It can be longer also. Now, what do you want to do inside the container? So I want to do update. Remember, update was needed to install anything because that's a very base image. So update. So I updated it. Now run. What do you want to do? Apt get install get hyphen y. Remember why I said you are going to interact. So these are the things. If you want to install, let's say Java, apt get install Java. Now Java OpenJDK. I forgot the command. OpenJDK. Here it is. And Debian, right? Here it is. OpenJDK, this is the package. Okay. Now, hyphen Y, you have to get it. So guys, like this, you will write. I'm just giving you just a simple ways to do that. But advancement, I will do that in some time. But this is the kind of things which you did, right? Okay. So now, what to do? Go ahead and cd create doc directory. CD doc directory and store the content whatever you written in a Docker file. This is a file. The file name can be anything. Understand that. File name can be anything, but default file which the Docker reads it is a Docker file. If you keep it the another file name, you have to use the hyphen f option. But not interested in a one go. So here, done. Did you understand these commands, guys, in a simple way? Guys, did you understand? This is something I did manually.
Yeah.
Something I did manually.
Yeah.
Now, what command you have to run it? Docker build. Remember, last time when you were committing the container layer, then it was trying, you are trying commit. But this time you are building the whole image from scratch. Okay. So build. What do you want to name it? Rajesh. Image one. Let's call it image one. And where is your context path? Where the Docker file and all the relative paths are there. Dot location, current location. That's all. And you see here, I'll explain you all these things in a simple way. Update is happening now. So it's automated actually. Everything, every step, whatever you feel like giving into the, and here you see, 7DK is not available. So why is not available? 8DK should be available then. Oh, it's a JDK 7. Okay, let's try this one. Okay. So it is not available. That does not mean the Docker file is mistake. It's your mistake. My mistake. Why? Because in Ubuntu, the repository which I loaded, apt-get, which has not a 7. No problem. So you have to add a repository or change the package, whatever you up to you. Typically, you will add the repository for 7. If you have a requirement for 7, you will not update it, of course. So, I rerun that command. And now you see here, there's a mismatch here. Why? So, this kind of error will come. So, manual things you have to do first. Then only you will understand the automation. Java is being installed, JDK 8.
It was asking for country code and time, right? How we can pass through?
That will throw an error. For that, we have to give that input. Let it come, let it prompt it. See, it is prompting it. So, how do we give it? So, basically, this is, we have to give it. There's a one way. I know that option, but I'm not able to recall that exact option. So, I will search in the Google. Just a second. apt-get silent install command options for what? Geography area. Okay. So these are the, you have to find out. I remember, but not able to remember right now. So some non-interactive function. apt-get, which is so they are asking to do non-interactive, but with the apt I want to use. So exactly what to have here, install dev function non-interactive. So this is also, it can be done, but I don't want it to pass non-interactive to environment. I want to pass through command line. So, is there any way? They are trying different way to feed that data, but I want to have a little. There is one parameter which I know that. This is an option, but okay. I want to avoid this option for time being because I want looking for the hyphen option. So that will be really for us. It's not found. Everywhere they are using this. Okay, let me see that Docker Hub Apache 2. Just a second. I'll see the implementation how these guys have done. Accordingly. So here, apt-get, no install recommended. I think this one. This option probably takes that issue. Okay? No install recommends. That's the one option. There is one more option is there. These are the options for the APT. No install recommendation. I think this should fix that issue. Let's try. And so, control C. And let's try here. Did you understand this? Not working actually. In that case, let's try that options also. depends on the version. So let me set this environment. Okay, so I'm changing this to what is the environment, I'll talk about little bit later. And should work because on Apache it was working. So we'll check later. And by the way, this geographical areas and all, this is asking from last 2 months only. Earlier the packages were not asking this information. You can feed this information much in advance, so this will not prompt you. Once you put this information for the next packages and all, it will not put you. So this is the one-time implementation you have to do now. You have to feed that information. Okay guys, so done, my image is done. You see here Docker images, image name was image 1 and I got it done. So this is the file which I have it, Docker file. I fetched it, also the error, I troubleshoot also. I did not explain you the behavior, but there are so many options also you have it. But this is the way you create images. Did you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. I need to explain you the behavior also, but I have a rules actually, and rules will only work if I teach you properly. So this is a command. Now I have a lab for volumes, and I think and this one. Okay, you do that, experience that, whatever you want to do, and assignment also. An assignment is very simple, which will help me to cover the next topic. I want to know assignment. Okay. I want to know what is the name of volume of Jenkins container. Understand that. Jenkins container. Okay, and where it is. And guys, please do that because my next topic is dependent on this. If you do not find that information, then you will not understand next topic. Okay, so what is the name of the volume of Jenkins container? What is the environment set in Jenkins container? Okay, that is the information. Jenkins container is running with which user? Yes, you have to find out, okay? Which user. Now so environment done, user done, environment done, user done, volume done. Jenkins container is running with which are the port. You need to find it out for me. So Jenkins port is done, user is done, volume is done, environment is done. Yeah, So these are the four questions you have to answer. Find out the answer. Let me tell you here. You will not understand the advanced program of software file if you do not find this information. Okay? So it's dependency. So this is a lab. You have to do that as I said. Okay? This is a lab also. And this is a sample.
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $399 plan and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.